put a body down. That's it, mate. If you're going to put a body down, that's up. No further discussion. Thanks, guys.
Why did you stay with them, sir? You're right, sir.
No, no, we know this. We know this. We've just been called here. That's so.
Yeah. Okay.
So God bless you, bro. Thanks a lot, mate.
Okay.
Thanks a lot, guys. Thanks, mate.
God bless you, sir. Have a good day.
Thanks a lot, guys. Thanks. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah, bro. Hey, man, we're doing. Sorry if the camera's waving. I didn't bring my stick and that, so.
Good afternoon, people of London. How are we doing today? In this beautiful sunshine. Today is the day that the Lord has made. Jesus Christ is alive. We are here to give you the good news of the message of God. Jesus came on earth, not for religious purposes, but he came on earth to save humanity, to save our soul from sin. The Bible says that sin is what separates us from God. And today, you have an opportunity, if you don't know God, to come through Jesus Christ. I'm sure you've seen the slogan, Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through Jesus. And that is what we're preaching today. If you want to come into the kingdom of God, if you want to come with God, there's only one way. No religion can get you there. No other religion could do that. Only Jesus Christ. His name means Yeshua, means Savior. And he saves us from our sin. Today is the day of salvation, people. Don't enjoy the sunshine and ignore the very one who created the sun. You're enjoying life, but you ignore the very one who created life. God has given us a will. You can choose life or death. And as a good God, he said, choose life today. And life is found in Jesus Christ. That's why we're out here today, to give you that good news, the message of God. Because the end is coming very soon. Jesus is coming. He's going to split the sky. He's going to be the brightest light, the highest high. And when he comes, he's not coming to save you, people. He's coming to judge. Because the Savior has come 2,000 years ago, and we have a chance now to be saved. But when he comes back again, he's coming back to judge. If you're a believer in him, you'll escape. If you don't believe in Jesus Christ, I don't want to be in your shoes. Because God is a just God. Just like when you break a law in this country, you will be penalized, whether you go to prison or you pay a fine. God is a just God. If you reject him, you will pay the price. As simple as that. But he has given you the will to accept him. He doesn't force people. He doesn't make you believe in him. He allows you. He gives you time. He gives you people like me and my brothers here to give you the message of the good news, madam. This message is for you. Don't get drunk. The Bible says the drunkards will not inherit the kingdom of God. Just the way you surrender your life to alcohol, just the way you surrender your life to cigarette, surrender your life to Jesus today, and you will see your life transformed. When you surrender your life to alcohol, what happens? We know what happens. Your liver gets damaged. Cigarette, your lung gets damaged. And then you fill up the NHS hospital and you complain that there are not enough doctors. Stop drinking and smoking. Come to Jesus Christ, who can save you from your bondage, from your trap.
Amen.
He can save you from that. Come to know him today.
Amen.
His kingdom is full of righteousness, peace, and joy. You will have that joy. But with your alcoholism, you may have temporary pleasure. It's not even pleasure, you're killing your body. But that will produce permanent pain. You don't want that. Don't have temporary pleasure for permanent pain. Come to God so you can be saved today. and you can have your soul set free. Jesus Christ said, what profits a man if you gain all the world, if you gain all the money you want in the world, if you gain all the relationships you want in the world? What profits you if you gain all of that but you lose your very soul? Your soul is important to God. Your soul is important to the devil. Who are you going to surrender your soul to? Very easy to surrender your soul to the devil. One example is right there. Drunkenness. That is one example. People love their sin. They love their sin because they think coming to God is some kind of restriction. But you be set free. Jesus said, whoever the Son set free is free indeed. You can be free, madam, today. It's a free gift. It doesn't cost you anything. But that alcohol, I bet, cost you so much money. But today you can give your life to God free of charge. And Jesus has opened his arms. And he is waiting for you and I to come to know him, to come to surrender your life, to come to submit your life to